TST, AMIT, Technology Enabling Center, TEC, which is organizing this patent, all about the IPR, intellectual property rights. Today, it's going to be more of hands-on. So without any rituals, we will straight away go to Dr. Amrish Chandra. And we are also fortunate to have Dr. B.C. Das and Dr. Dilip Upadhyay joining. Founder President is also seeing the program straight from this program. And yesterday, he spent the whole day with us, almost 3 hours. It's a precious time. And also, the Chancellor, both the Chancellors, that is Dr. Atul Chauhanji as well as Dr. Asim Chauhanji could also join us. It's great occasion. That means how much importance the higher management is giving to this program. I want you to appreciate all the participants. That is AMIT. That is AMIT. We just don't leave it to the group head or head of the institution. At the topmost level, the attention is being given to research, innovation, IPR, technology transfer. That is AMIT. I want you to realize that. And I was so happy yesterday, more than 600 people registered for this, and they were attending that all through. It's very gratifying. The efforts of AMIT is paying dividend. You people are going to be the future. The participants who are attending, you are the future. And so be just innovative in imbibing everything Dr. Amrish Chandra is saying. And that is very important so that you become specialist in IPR and other domains. We don't know how many of you will get into the IPR domains after your PhDs and so on. So with this, I welcome everyone, including Dr. B.C. Das, Dr. Dilip Upadhyaya. And Dr. Amrish, please go ahead straight away to the program. Yes, sir. And go ahead. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I heartily welcome Dr. Sarvamurthy sir, Dilip Upadhyay sir, our honorable respected B.C. Das sir, and thanks, many thanks to Nishi ma'am and to the IT support team for arranging everything for the today's event. So beginning with the patent search, basically.
Show it on full screen, huh?
Should I put it on full screen? Okay.
Right, that's it. We can see it very well. Go ahead.
So there are various free patent databases that can be used for patent searching. So participants can take a screenshot of this for their ready reference in the future also. So today we are going to study, basically there are Google patents, free patents online, patent scope, eSpace, USPTO and IPO, that is the Indian patent search engine. So basically, we'll deal with the patent scope, which is a global patent database of more than 89 million records over there. So the website that you need to go is https://vipo.int. This is the website there where you go. And here you navigate to the column of resources. And when you come to the resources panel, there is an option for patent scope. And you can click on this patent scope and you will be directly reaching to a panel which looks something like this. You will not see your name and other details here because you're not logged in, but almost all the features are the same. So here you will get various options if you click this. So this is the front page and then application, full text and other things. So you just need to enter the search term over here. So if you add the search term, say natamycin, it's the name of a drug that I have added. So when you add this term over here, you will get a searches. And searches would look something like this. And if it does not look like this, then over here there is a list kind of a button over here. You press this and it will toggle between the full display list and divided list. So you will be having two portions. On one portion, you can see the list of the patents that have been filed. And on the other side, you can actually read the patents. So there will be national biological data. So it's like it's from the Office of Korea. This is the application number, application date. And other details will be found over here. When you go to the description column, you will see the full description of the patent and everything. And once you go further, you will get the claims option where you can see the claims and drawings. And if there are some chemical compounds, you can also see the chemical compounds over here. and then if there are some documents which are uploaded. So participants, if they can, they have their laptops ready with them, they can just type in vpo.ind and you can go to the website and you can give me a feedback continuously on the chat whether you were able to open it or not, or if you found some problem over there in logging into the site. And if you don't have any problem, I will go ahead with the discussions. Okay. And so Netamaitin was okay, fine. So I got 822 results for this. So it's comparatively manageable still. But suppose if I want to search for eye drops, okay. So it could be your term, your technical term that you want to think, your UG thesis or your PG, PhD thesis work, if you want to search whether they are novel or not, or some kind of research work that you are doing. And if you want to see whether it's patentable or whether it's novel or not, you can do it. So when I put the terms eye drop, it gives me 24,454 results. Now, these huge number of results, or sometimes the results can come in even lakhs. So these results are not manageable and it's not possible for anyone to go through all these 24,000 records and search for it. And here you will see that FP represents the front page. So the front page would basically be the title and other details. So that is what it is. Copyright law, someone is asking, but we'll discuss this later. It's not in the scope of the presentation. So how do we narrow down the results overall? So the first thing is that Boolean search is something that we have commonly known, but we have rarely used. And one good thing is that these Boolean searches not only work in patent searching, it also works very well in Google Scholar. It also works on a simple Google website, a Google search that you do. And you can use these Booleans to search even Google terms. So often we find that when we use Google, we're not able to find what we want to search. So using these terms, you will be able to narrow down your searches. So Boolean search is A and B. So if you say, if you're using the word and, so only the terms which contain both the terms A and B will be filtered out. And if you're using and not, so you, only the terms of A will be filtered out and not of B. So this is called as and not function. And simply it can also be written as not. In Google or some of the websites, even using a minus sign, just a minus sign in front of the word without any space also does this same job. When we say or, it means both A and both B. So either it's A or B or both, they're taken out. When you say XOR, it basically means it will be having either A or B, but not the terms which are having both A and B. So that is the difference between or and XOR. Near means if one word and the other words are near to each other, adjacent and same. So we'll explain them in detail. So when you say tennis and ball, so documents having both the words will be filtered. Tennis and not is the Boolean and ball. So when you use this, it says that documents having the word tennis but not the ball will be filtered out. Tennis or ball, it means either the word tennis or ball or both. So or is what it denotes. When you are using a term X or, it basically means documents having either of the word tennis or ball, but not both. Okay, so this is what it is. Then further going down the line, we have truncations. So truncations are nothing but asterisk marks, question mark, dollar sign, or the percentage sign. So depending on the database that you are using, for different databases, it could be different. So patent scope uses asterisk mark. So suppose if you want to search for electricity, you know, it could be electric, electrical, electricity, electronic, or anything. So you just put the word elect, E-L-E-C-T, and put a star over here, which will give you the terms electricity, electrical, electron, okay, election, electoral. All these terms will be included in the search. Okay. So whether it is electric, electricity, or some singular or plural terms, all the terms will be included by using this truncations. Then there's another thing which is called as nesting. So when you say nesting, it suppose example, we have a tennis ball or racket and you want to search. So when you are going to search for tennis and ball or racket, so there'll be two potential searches outcome to be resolved. Okay. So tennis ball and racket. And if you put a bracket around tennis and ball, so what will happen? So tennis and ball should be there, or they should be bracket. So documents having either the word tennis or ball or the word bracket is to be used. And if you put the bracket on the other side, it will be documents having the word tennis and either of the words ball or bracket. So this is how the things work. Some of the participants wants the video, probably will be recording the video and sharing it, not the presentation itself. Phrases are created by using quotations. So if we are using quotations, just double quotation marks, you will be able to search. So if you're just putting tennis and ball, so it is the search engine treats tennis under quotation and ball under quotation. So it searches for both the terms tennis and ball, and you get too many results. But if you put the term, entire term, tennis ball under inverted commas, the results will be much sharper, and only those results which are containing both the terms, the tennis and the ball, will be available in the search. There's another Boolean term which is called as near. So now suppose you are using a word tennis and ball, and you are not, it's not always that the tennis and ball come together. Sometimes the inventor or the applicant is very clever, and he might have written a ball used to play tennis. So the ball and tennis are not together, but they are separated by a single word. Or sometimes it can be separated by 3 words, 5 words, 10 words, 100 words, whatever it is. So in this term, what you can use the word tennis, near ball. And with the near, you can add a numerical also, value also. So it could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, any numerical value. So the distance between, the difference between the tennis and the ball, if it is like say 5, so if there are difference of 5 words between the two things, even then the thing will be captured in the search. Similarly, it is before. If one of the terms you know it comes, should be coming before the other term, you can use the term before, and again you can put the numerical value in front of it. It could be any numerical value from 1 onwards. And when you're using the terms ADJ, so it means adjoining basically, and it means that one of the terms is closer to the other. So the, both the terms should be close to each other, and they should be in the same order. And when you're using the term same, it does not matter whether the word is coming before or after. It is just that it's in the same paragraph. So sometimes it happens that we are not very sure whether the word is before it or after it or how near it is. But we are very much sure that if there's an invention, both the words will be repeated in the same paragraph. So we can use the word same. Now, in the earlier example slide, when we started this Boolean terms, the front page contained eyedrops word, but there was no bracket or nesting into it. So we got some 24,000 results, and just by nesting it inside the bracket, the results drastically reduced to 3,241. So this is how it works. Now, if I use a further Boolean, say near 5. So we studied about how to use the word near 5. So you can say I near 5 drop. So the drop could be either 5 words before or 5 words after the word I. So this reduced from 3,000 to 2,000 words. And in the initial search that we did with Natamycin, where we got 822 results, and if we use it Natamycin and eyedrop, if we use it together, it means that we got very few results, say 3 results. But I would say this is narrowing down it too much. So if you narrow down a search very precisely, and you say, okay, I'm so lucky that I did not find anything on this particular portal, so can I patent it? So let me tell you a word of caution that there are two things. One is a patent, and the other is called as the non-patent literature. So we have patent literature and non-patent literature. So non-patent literature includes all the brochures, the white papers, executive summary, the journals that publish the paper, the books there are that are there in the market. So you need to do a thorough searching, not only on the patent websites, on the patent databases, but also on this. Patent scope is widely used because it's a huge database of a lot many countries, and more than 89 million records they have as of date. So when you are using brackets or nesting, if you miss a bracket over here, so here I have put one bracket and I miss the other bracket. So they are saying, it's saying that unbalanced parenthesis. So you need to balance the parenthesis properly. So if you make a more complicated search, you say I near drug 5 and say this is a name of a compound which is a viscosity enhancing agent. So it's an excipient that is added to the eye drops to make it a little more viscous so that it's not as liquid. It stays in the eye for a longer duration. So I've added the term and hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose. So this inventors or applicants might write it as a full term, or they can write it as HPMC. So when you're using this whole term, you're getting just one result out of it. So again, this is how you can work out the various things. So when you go to the option, this was simple search. So here you will have different options. One of them will be simple search. The second one would be, say, advanced search. So when you go for advanced search, you don't get a line, but you get a bracket kind of a thing. So here you can add a lot more text. Even you can add a small two lines, three line or a paragraph into it. And the good thing is that once you enter the thing, it will automatically find out the things, and it will give you how much result is coming out of it. So there's another thing which is called as advanced search. So this is how it is done. So in advanced search, if you're using different terms, so we say this is the term which was used in example. So EN represents English. All text means all the text. So it includes the title, the abstract, the description, the claims, everything is included. So all text. The searching is electric near 5 car. So this is basically a search for electric car. And it's a battery, obviously it's an electric car, so it would be having a battery, but sometimes patent searcher wants to make it short. So he's also using the term circuit here. And he has used and he wants to search only for the patents which have been filed or published in 2019, because say he must have filed a patent in 2018 and now he wants to see has anybody later on filed a patent similar to my patent or not. So he's using the term DP. DP is the date of publication. So the date of publication should be 2019, or the priority date, that is PD, should be 2019. So such kind of terms can also be used in carrying out patent searches. Then there's an option of field combinations. So here you can use various terms like and, at not, ex nor. So there are different terms that can be found using this drop-down menu. And then there are various field combinations. So front page, application number, abstract, full text. So whatever different things that you want to search, you can search. You can add the things over here. So here I added, say, I near 5 drops. And when I add this, I get a link over here. So I can see I've got something 2000 results over here. And then there is an option for ticking this. This is called a steaming. So steaming, suppose you want to search for a word cell and cells. So it's not possible to use all the time, all the plurals. So you can just, if you are ticking this, both the term cell and cells will be counted. Okay. However, the word cellular will not be counted. So if you want to search the word cellular and you want to use the word cell in your search, then you will have to use a truncation. A truncation is nothing but an asterisk mark. Okay. That we studied, that was elaborated just a while ago. Okay. So down the line, you have this option, which is called a single family member. So what happens? Most of the patent applications, when they are filed in a particular country, they're also filed in other countries in order to get global coverage for the patent. So in this particular case, what happens if you tick this particular, if without ticking, say you are getting 2000 results. So once you tick this, only one patent will be represented only one single time in the patent search. So it does not reduce the number of patents. It just merges the different patents that are there into a single patent. With the same application number. So you get 1731 patents over here. So you're seeing this thing, and here you see steaming is on, and you see single family member is true. The language is English, and we have offices here. It represents all offices. So if you click this option of offices all, you get an option to edit the offices that you want to search. So you can search India, Germany, Japan, Korea, wherever you want to search by single country, you can search. You know, and if you select all, it will be a global search. Now, why is it needed to search a few countries? Why don't we search with all the offices every time? Now, suppose if you have a patent in India and you want to sell a particular patent on, say, Amazon, or you want to sell a particular product in India only. So it is very important to do a search for freedom to operate. Now, freedom to operate means it's a very complicated thing. Like, suppose I make a pen, okay? So I make the pen, the refill, the body and the cap and everything. But unfortunately, the clip of the cap has been patented by someone else. And I am also using a cap with a clip. So though I have the right to make the body, the refill and the cap, but I don't have the permission to put the clip on the cap. So that is what is called as the freedom to operate. So though I can make a pen, but I cannot put a clip on it. So that is what is called as freedom to operate. And then there's an option for filters. If you click this bar graph kind of a thing, you will get various filters. So you can see the countries which have been filing the maximum number of patents, who are the main applicants. So this number of applicants also gives you an idea of who are the most likely companies where you can collaborate, or who are the companies with whom you can sell your patent. So these are the companies, since they are working largely on this particular invention. So these are the companies most likely to buy your patent, or you can find a joint venture or a collaboration with these companies. Here you get the list of inventors. So if you follow these inventors, surely they will be working more on this particular aspect. So you can trace their patents, their publications, and you can know what in which direction they are going. And if possible, you can also look for a further collaboration with these inventors. So you can make a good network team with them. And then you have a dicey looking numbers over here, which is called as IPC code. So IPC code, it looks like A61K, A61P and so on. So someone will be having B, K, C, so G02. So these are IPC codes. And then we have publication dates. So 2011, we had 53 publications. 12, we had 49 patents and so on. Now, when you talk of IPC code, IPC code is nothing. It can be found on this website, WIPO International Classification, IPC. Okay. And it's basically all the patents are classified into these many categories, 8 categories. And A is for human necessity. So I was searching for eye drops, and eye drops are a part of medical facilities or medical necessity, and they come under human necessity. So they are classified into A and further classified into 61K. So that is how the classification works. So performing operations, transporting, C is chemistry, D is textile, E is fixed construction, and F, G, H, and so on. So by looking at the various classification, and when you click this positive button, you will further be getting a whole list of classifications where you can search in which category your patent lies. Again, this IPC code can also be used to narrow down your patent searching procedures. You also get some very good looking charts over here. Not very good looking, but still quite effective. So here you get a pie chart for China filing the maximum patents, Japan, US, and so on. So you can get similar charts for this also. Sometimes you will find that the patents are not in English language, but they're in Chinese, Korean, or some other language. So the site is provided with an automatic translation tool. There's an option for WIPO Translate and a Google Translate. So I usually go with Google Translate because it's much easier, more friendly kind of a thing. So however, it's your choice. You can try both of them, and whatever suits you, you can go for it. So all the options are available to all the participants. And however, when you go for a login option, so some of the people might find a login option over here. And since today morning, there has been some problem on the WIPO site. So some participants might not find this login information. So if they have a login, it's fine. They can click this. And if they don't have an account, they can create an account. It's free. There are no charges for creating an account on WIPO IP portal. So once you create a login ID and a password, you will be able to log in. And after logging in, the same features which were presented earlier would remain over there, but you will also get a few extra features. So you log in into it. And once you log in, you get two additional features over here. One is the ability to download the results. So you can download the results in batches of 100, the first 100 results, or you can download the first 10,000 results. So if your search is giving say 2 lakh results or 24,000 results or something, you will obviously not be able to download all the results, but 10,000 results up to you can download. The second option you will be getting after you log in is an option to save the query. So this portal, when you log in, you will have your name over here and you will get this option of saving your query, so that you don't need to type those complicated Boolean terms and everything every time again. You can just search, save it. And all this search that you do can be found out in this column over here on the top left hand corner that you have menu. So here you can find all the terms over here. Further, there's an option which is called as Vipo Pearl, not much used by most of the inventors because it's not very popular. However, this particular option gives you an option to get the results in this kind of a format. So English eye drops, and then you have different languages. You find the results in different languages also over here. And you can find patent scope images. So if you click images, all English patents or something, English, all patents in English language or any all searches with English language having the word eye drops, all images you can find. Okay. And then there's an option for concept map. And if you click the concept map, you get a picture like this. So it says that most of the patents were filed in science or medicine and chemistry. And few had some relation with the data, and then electricity and environment, food and so on. So this is kind of a map that you get. So this will not help much, but if you click this things, you will be going into the particular domain and you can search what kind of science applications were filed, what kind of eye drop applications were filed in say food or energy or kind of thing. Okay. And so we end this particular thing for patent searching. Let me have your feedback about could you engage into it, could you log into it, or if you want some time to log into the portal and see how the things are working, that would also be good enough. So I will be waiting for your chats. Can I have some feedback from you? Yes, login is indeed disabled. So if you want to log in, go to Vipo portal. And from there, you can choose some other category. Say in the second column, you have an option for classification. So you can go to the classification thing. So over here, you can go to international classification in the second column. Here, when you go inside this, you will get an option for login. So when you click login, you will be able to create an account. Thank you. Mr. Sameer is saying a very good presentation. Thank you, Sameer. Samar. What is meant by international classification is I showed you international classifications. Okay, so it's basically an agreement between different countries that this is how they will be classifying the different patents. So that is what is called as international classification. So if you want to find out the say expiry date of a patent, say prothioconazole, you need to go and search with priority date. So when you search for priority date, you can be sure that after 20 years, the patent would be expiring. So country specific and international patent search. International patent search is global patent search, while country specific is just for a country, basically done for to find out freedom to operate. So freedom to operate is again an option where you find out whether you will be particularly able to use a technique or not. Suppose, for example, How is this patent platform different from Google Patent? So Google Patent does have these options, but they don't give you a more classified graphical representations and all those things. Google Patent Search is, however, much easier to use. You don't need to create an account over there. And the translation is also comparatively easy. But this patent PCT, patent scope feels more like an authentic kind of a software. So we particularly use this.
Amrish,
yes, Amrish, sir.
Alpana Kakkar is asking, what is freedom to operate? Freedom to operate, expand on that.
Okay, so freedom to operate basically is like, suppose there is a, I have been doing a lot of research on say cancer, okay. And I find that this is a particular molecule, a new molecule, which is very good, and it can be useful for cancer. So I do a lot of research on it, and I make a tablet is already available. So what I do is I make a capsule or I make an injectable out of that particular drug. Okay. Now when I go and file a patent and a patent searching is done, so no one finds that there is no injection for a particular drug that I'm working on. So my invention is entirely novel because there was a drug molecule and its solubility was very less. So nobody could make an injection out of it, but I was the only one who made the injection out of it. So I go and file a patent and I get the patent and everything done. So there's no issue with it. That all is done. Now what happens when I go and file a patent, I will be getting a patent will be granted to me. But when I go and market it, the company who is making that particular molecule will say, you, this particular molecule belongs to me. I have a patent on it. So how, though the injection is patented to me, but the molecule is patented to that particular person. So I cannot use that patented molecule in my injection and market it. So that is what is called as the freedom to operate.
So, yeah,
when you are filing a patent, you need to see that the all the components, the various components that are included in the production of that particular device or that formulation or composition, they are all patent free. That is what is patent freedom to operate. Is there any registration? No, there's no registration charges. It's free. WIPO is entirely free. What is the main difference between work that is novel and one that can be patented? All novel works can be patented, but the decision to go for patent is entirely on you because it involves time, money, and effort.
Yeah. Amrish. This Dilip here, it is very important to tell people that what is patent and freedom to operate, because many of us think that once I patent, I can market. Patenting and freedom to operate are very important from industry point of view. It is very, very important.
Yeah. So I just with an example, probably yeah, I was able to clear the doubt that all the components, all the various components that go into your product.
Correct.
So there are two things, either you make a product or you make a process. So if you're making a product, a pen, so the cap, the clip, the refill and everything will be patented. Okay. Everything will be your components. Okay. And if you're making a process, say you are synthesizing something, A plus B plus C is equal to D. So, and you're using various reagents and various apparatuses for it. Okay. So all those components need to be checked thoroughly before you launch your product into the market that they don't infringe upon something. Again, there are something very interesting. There are a few companies which don't charge you, they don't sue you, they don't put a court case on you for using their components, their equipments for research purpose. Getting it? So,
yeah.
For example, there's a stain GFR14, which is used as a fluorescent dye. So if you're using it for research purpose, there will be no problem. But if you are using that particular product for your analysis and you are trying to sell it in the market, they will come and ask a royalty for that. So certain companies allow freedom there's no freedom, there's no restriction on use for research. But when you go and commercialize that particular thing, they come up and they say that you are earning profit, give us also a share of your profit.
Dr. Amrish, Bindu is asking, where can I find patents related to electronics? Patents related to electronics.
Ma'am, I say electronics is a very broad term. So if you just narrow, if you can narrow it down and you can just type the few words in a patent scope, you will get a lot of patents over there. So you can just go through a few patents and then you can find out whether those patents are relevant or not, and then you can further use Boolean searches and other things to narrow down your search. Just for electronics and everything, you can find all the patents anywhere. There's no problem with that.
Dr. Amrish, another question from Dr. Sridhar from Amity University, Haryana. How is this platform different from Google patent search platform?
So I just replied to that. This is a more sophisticated platform. You have options to download the queries. You have options to save the queries after logging in. You get some nice graphical representations of concept maps, so such things. But these things are not available on Google Patent. So Google Patent is more like a Google search with a good database of patents, patent thing.
And so Viposite, Nutan Kaushik is asking, Viposite contains only PCT. Are all patents filed in different countries?
No, ma'am. It contains all the patents filed in different countries. So it has PCT plus different countries. So there are all the countries. So they have gotten around 89 million records over there. So the website itself says that they have PCT plus patent application from all the member countries. So there are more than 129 member countries, I believe, over there. So they have patent applications from all the countries.
Another question is, pharmaceutical patents lie in which category? Pharmaceutical patents.
Pharmaceutical patents, they mostly in IPC category, they will lie in A category. Most of them will fall in A61K.
Right. Dr. Mala Tendon wants to know, please, could you give the website to register on Patent Scope?
Currently, I told you the website is down for Patent Scope, but I told you the option to it. So you need to go to the site bepo.int. The Patent Scope option will not work. So in the second column, the third last option, International Classifications, you can click over here. So when you click this option of International Classifications, then it will lead to your page. Then you get a option for assessing the database. Click that link. And then you will find a link for login on the top. You click that and you can register from there. The Patent Scope site also has this option, but currently it's been down from the early morning today.
Mr. Sudhanshu Tripathi wants to know, if my design is ready, but my prototype model is not ready, can I file my patent?
Surely, sir, you can file a patent with the design. There's no doubt about it. However, the only criteria for filing a patent is that the description should enable the reader to reproduce your invention. So by studying the design, if one is able to reproduce your things, you can it is fine. But during development of prototype, if you find that certain things need to be added, deleted or changed, then it's probable that you first go for a prototype and then you file for a patent. Or you go for a provisional one right now and go for a complete specification once you have sure with the details. Because all the claims that you make in the patent, they need to be supported by the description of the invention. So if the description is weak, your patent will not stand the ruggedness of an opposition in case it comes in the future.
But design registration can be done, Amrish?
Yes, design registration is a altogether different category that can be done. But again, if during prototype development, he finds that the thing should not be rotated this way, should be rotated this other way, or should be coiled or something design, then again, that would be a new design registration. Because in designs, we don't have a provisional and a complete registration.
Absolutely. Thank you. Another question is, are there any registration or access charges for the site?
No, sir. It's free of cost. There's no charges for this database.
Then another question from Ms. Cheryl Sachdeva. What is the main difference between a work that is novel and the one that can be patented?
So I think, sir, these are top questions. I have already answered them, sir. I was continuously going through their chat and I have answered most of them.
Right. Natural product and the process, is it patentable?
Yes, it is patentable.
Prakash Gowda.
It is patentable, but the details need to be looked into what is available in the literature and what are the technical advancements in your particular application?
Dr. Sunita wants to know, can an expedited examination application be applied online under this act?
Yes, for expedited application, only online mode can be done. There is no paper filing for expedited examination.
Are you going to give some hands-on practice, Amrish?
If the users can just log into their portal VPOINT and go to Patent Scope, they can try hands-on to it. And if they have some problems, we can discuss those.
Another question is, how do I file patent on artificial intelligence and machine translation? Dr. Pankaj Goswami is asking.
So there are a lot of patents on artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is basically a software, and AI will not go alone as a software. There will be obviously some hardware attached to it, be it a camera, a scanner or anything. So you can obviously, in combination with hardware, you can file for a patent. There's no issue with that.
Very good. And Dr. Ranjana Rajneesh is asking, where can we check for patents in software?
Again, patent in software, you need to use the keyword software. Algorithm would be another keyword. Programming would be another keyword. And which application you want to use, that would be another keyword. So by using the combination of these keywords, you will be able to find software patents on Google Patent or Patent Scope also.
Dr. A.K. Singh wants to know, can we file patent for the research done on paper packaging industry where product guava is taken as the part of research packaging?
So if the packaging has your technology or your invention has increased the strength of the packaging, the durability, the water resistance or some technical advancement, or if it has been able to reduce the cost, so you can file a patent for that.
Dr. Amina Babu wants to know, if it is an IT startup and they want to patent it, how do they go about it?
So if you are a startup and you are registered with the as a startup, you can file a patent. And for the startups, the fees won't be a higher fees. It would be same as that for a natural person, which were elaborated yesterday.
And they also can have priority in terms of publication.
Examination, and you can also find a large number of patent facilitators on the website of the DPPI, and from there, those patent agents would be happy to file your patent free of cost, though you have to pay the government fees, but the patent agent fees would be waived off. Because the government will be paying them the fees.
Yeah, Mr. Tungri wants to know, how to come across information of patent application that are not published or completed or complete 18 months of filing. So is there a way to look at even those which are not published but filed?
No, those which are not published, they are kept for 18 months or until early publication. So that is a fail-safe mechanism prepared by the government. Across the globe, it's not only for India, all the countries honor this kind of a thing. And only once they are published, they can be searched.
Amrish, I would like to share one real incident. What we used to do on a Japanese company for which Uma used to work, what we used to do, you know, we used to file a patent and then before 18 months we'll withdraw it. Filing will give us a priority date, and basically, as you said correctly yesterday, that patents are to protect other, like creating a fort for yourself and protecting others to come into your territory. So before 18 months we'll withdraw. So the people will not know what we are doing. And then again, we will file with little difference. So that's the trick which Japanese company used.
Yes. So the patent application can be withdrawn at 15 months. So after 15 months, you will not be able to withdraw. But on 15 months, you can withdraw that application.
Yeah. So until 18 months, nobody can see your data. That's for sure.
And during this time, if you find that certain inventors or your competitors have started working on it, you can go ahead with that application and let it get published.
Correct. You have a priority date. So that's a real trick I think many of us can use, especially those who are having a very advanced prototype available.
Yes.
Again, Dr. Alpana Kakkar wants to know, can you take example of a software or computer science side patent? Also, if a proposed prototype model is given in research is published in any journal, can we go for its patent?
So if it is your own publication published within the last 1 year, yes, you can go for a patent. And if it is a publication done by someone else, you need to consult someone more legally strong in the field so that he will be able to advise whether he can go for a patent or not. There are various factors that come into play when we talk of patent and publication. So during the claim drafting presentation in the next one, we'll be discussing about what are the intricacies of a claim drafting. So you need to see what all has been already reported in the publication and what is the left to be reported. So that part you can highlight and you can protect that part.
Thank you, Amrish. Another question from Dr. Vinamara Sharma. New combination of traditional drugs with a new indication, can that be patented? New combination of traditional drugs with a new indication, can it be patented?
So now he's asking for two things. One is a new combination. So if he says it's a new combination, obviously it can be patented. But if he says a new indication or a new use is not patentable in India. And we also need to see whether the different components that you are using, 2, 3, 5, whatever components you are using. If one of those components are already reported, he has to prove a synergistic activity and efficacy for his composition in order to be able to get a patent, successful patent.
Right. And Mr. Prakash Gowda asking, what is the role of NBA while patenting natural organisms? Any set of guidelines from NBA available?
NPA, I'm not getting you. What is NPA?
No, National Biodiversity Authority, NBA.
So NBA does mandate that you need to deposit the organism to MTCC culture collection in India. So there is a fees for that. So by paying that fees, you need to deposit that culture before you file the patent. So that is important to know that when you file the application, patent application, the deposition number should be there on the patent. That can be deposited, but the date of deposition should be before the date of filing the patent.
Dr. Sapna Sharma wants to know, can there be any patent filing in humanities?
Obviously, there can be a lot many patents in humanities.
Examples?
If you are doing something for the, say, for some psychological kind of a work, it can probably lead to some benefit in mental health or something. So the patents can be designed in such a way that they have this thing. But again, as I said earlier, patents need to have financial, they involve a lot of time, money and effort. So you need to see whether you will be able to recover that money out of your patent or not.
Mr. Mandeep Mittal wants to know, my research area is supply chain management. We do mathematical modeling and find the optimal solutions, optimal policies for supply chain. Supply chain management and publish research papers in SCI journal, Scopus Index journal. Please suggest how can we file patent in that supply chain management or mathematical modeling, that related areas, optimal solutions, optimal policies, solutions, can it be patented?
So as such, mathematical formulas or theories or those things are not allowed to be patented as such. But if you if the theory converts into an application kind of a thing, those applications can be patented. So if you finally convert your theory or your findings into a software and it is attached with the hardware, say a scanner or anything kind of a thing, then you stand a chance for filing a patent. But not the theoretical work as such.
Right. And Mr. Tungri Ghosh wants to know, can we withdraw a patent application after its filing? It's examination in Form 18.
You can withdraw the patent anytime you want. There's no issue with it. But if you withdraw it before 15 months, it won't be published. But even if it's once published, you always have the right to withdraw the patent. And there are no charges to withdraw the patent. So it's the applicant who basically has the right to withdraw the patent or not. It's not the inventor who has the right to withdraw it or not.
What are the different databases or tools available for direct patent mapping, Mr. Samyak Nag wants to know, what are the different databases or tools available for direct patent mapping?
So patent mapping is again, it's an advanced tools. The free softwares won't give you that kind of information. There are various law firms across the globe which have their own in-house patent mapping softwares. So it's a paid service by different people, but there's no free software as such, as per my knowledge, current knowledge.
Now, Ms. Vandana wants to know, can a concept be patented? Only a concept, can that be patented? If no, wet lab data is possible in 18 months required for filing complete patent. How to protect the idea? You have an idea.
Concept, you can go for a provisional patent, but not for a complete patent. So you can file a provisional patent, but that needs to be supported by the description of the invention within a year. So if you report something in the concept note and you file something else in the complete specification, some of the points that you file later on, you might not get the priority date for the provisional application. So suppose in the concept note, if you're filing 5 points, and when you're finding the complete application, you file 5 more points. So 5 of the points which were earlier in the concept note, they might get a priority date of the earlier one. But those 5 new points that you're filing, they will get the priority date of the date within 12 months when you're making a complete application.
I think now you can proceed, Amrish. You have answered very satisfactorily with every doubts, clarification. You can move ahead.
Sure, sir. So I believe everyone has gone through that particular document which was shared earlier. And if not, again, like it's the same thing. You can send me a WhatsApp message and I'll be sending you the details immediately.
So how do you make the claim now? You know, how do we write a very strong claim? That is the most powerful in patent. So you can go ahead on making, how do we frame the claims? Because, you know, as an inventor, they should be able to tell the patent agent or patent attorney that this is what is my claim that which I am making based on the scientific data. And over to you, Dr. Amrish, in terms of claims in a patent.
Thank you, sir. So we discuss a case. So keeping in view the versatility of the people that we have, so there will be people from pharmacy, biotech, engineering, nanotech, and all different branches, physiotherapy and everything. So this particular presentation was made in keeping in view our general point of view, nothing very specific. And my aim in this presentation, obviously I will fail to make you an expert in drafting claims, but I will surely give you an idea of what goes into drafting a claim, okay? So the next time when you read your own patent or you read a patent from a website, you will be able to understand what all the things are.
Dr. Amrish, I will just intervene here. What Dr. Selvamurthy has said, I will add to it that claim identification is the most crucial things.
Yes,
and
sir, exactly, sir.
Not that stops there. After claim identification, how you justify? Because majority of the time, the patent attorney is not an expert in all things. You see, we had got defeated. I got defeated at the last moment in the US patent, because that attorney was not able to understand the biological principle. And I conveyed to the Indian attorney, and Indian attorney conveyed to the US attorney. So it becomes a communication gap or something. And even in India also, those are attorney, they have come from the, not from biology, most of them are from the other background. If you are biology background, if you are giving a physics or chemistry, then you will have a problem. So the inventor has to find out a real good claim and their justification, and that to be paid to the attorney, that these are the justification you have to put forward to the when he is arguing the case. The attorney has to be made understand the all the claim justification also. So please go ahead. Thank you.
So, very right, sir. Absolutely right, sir. Basically, what I tend to explain someone who wants to do it. So I say that the a doctor-patient relationship and a inventor-patent agent relationship is same. So if a patient does not tell his all disease and all symptoms to the doctor will not be able to treat that patient.
Good analogy.
Wants to hide something from the patent agent and he says, no, if I tell him, he will steal my invention.
He will get
leaked out. If he does not disclose each and everything, he is not frank about the pros and cons of his invention, then again, the things don't work out in the benefit of the inventor. So it's always to have a very good relationship with the patent agent, be very frank with the person who is handling your intellectual property rights, have full faith on that person. If possible, sign an NDA with the patent agent. Okay.
Yes.
But whenever you go for it, either you have faith on him or you don't file a patent. So these are the two things. So very thank you, sir, for a very insightful story about it. It's very true. It's true for many, many of them. So when we file a patent application and when we talk of a complete patent application, basically, it has the following parts. It has got a title of the patent, the background. Background is much similar to literature review. The summary of the invention or the objectives, explanation of the patent drawings, description of the invention, claims, abstract and drawings. So out of all these things, neither the title nor the background nor the summary or anything is what the court of law will fight or you will claim other than the patent claims. So in abstract, you can write anything. In title, you can put any title. Nobody will question you for it as such unless it is very vague. But what is most important is the patent claim. So claim is the heart of the patent application. It defines the scope. And most of the time, a patent examiner will either only first or only read the claims of the invention. And claims are legally operative part of the patent application. So if you are sued or you want to sue someone, it is the claims that are taken hold of. Claims don't stand alone as such. So if you write something XYZ in the claims, they need to be supported by the description of the invention. So one example, suppose if I say that I say ki I write an invention in which I say that if you wear this parachute, you can and you jump from the building, or if you wear a shirt, say a blue color shirt, and you jump from a building and you will be able to fly. So if you find a novelty search for it, go through it, there won't be any problem.
Okay.
The claims would be absolutely fine. But if I'm not able to explain how this particular shirt helps me in flying, then I will be very weak in the disclosure part and I will not be getting a patent for it. Patent claim design is basically related that your patent claim should not be very broad and it should not be very narrow. But in fact, it should have both the components. It should have some broad components and some narrow components. So tomorrow, if you want to stop someone, you use the broader claims. And if you want to save yourself or your patent, you use the narrow claims. So you should have a patent application should have both the broad and the narrow claims. That's why in most of the applications, you would see the patent claims sometimes go to 100, 150, 200 claims also. Okay. However, the government of India permits you to file only 10 claims for free within the fees of 1600. But most of the companies who have a strong patent, they would go beyond 10 claims so as to make their patent application a lot more stronger than their competitors. So for example, when you're using the words, you should not use negative words. So if you say a tire that is not solid, okay. So you can write such a word, but it's not very clear that if it's not solid, what it is basically. Okay. So you can either say that a hollow tire. So that is more descriptive and more clear. So these kind of words should be used. Further, when you're using relative words like fast, slow, long, short, so such words should ideally be avoided unless you can show that within the same claim that they are longer and shorter than the other one. And whenever you put a claim, you should take into the concept that you should avoid any unnecessary limitations. So any limitations, so if you are making nanoparticles, you should not write that I am making nanoparticles of 20 nanometer. because they can be 25 also, they can be 30 also, they can be 50 also. So unnecessary limitations should not be there. And whenever you are filing claims, you should have an eye on the prior art, what the prior art has already said, and so that you define claims accordingly. When we talk of invention, basically there are two types. Either there will be a product or there will be a process. Okay. So product, as I told you, a pen is a product, but a process could be like, say, A plus B plus C will make D. It could be a chemical synthesis process or some other process. So if you have a kind of a thing which is called as a product or an apparatus, the examples include a chemical compound, compounds for pharmaceuticals, a composition, mixture, alloy, food or drink. So these are all products. Apparatus, instrument, machines, a system of cooperating apparatus, merging all the apparatus together. And then you have process patents, a method of preparation of a compound or something, method of analysis or a method of treatment or something. Use patent, use of product, application of a process, used to prepare a medicament for the treatment. So these are use patents. So when you have see a claim, the claim has got three parts basically, the preamble, the transition phase and the body. So this is how the patent goes basically. So preamble basically defines the category. So an apparatus, a device, an article, a composition or a method. So this is how you start your patent application, patent, the first patent with. And examples include an apparatus for, suppose if you want to cook rice, you can just write an apparatus for cooking. If you want to cook grains, you can write, say, and if you want to be specific, like you know that already someone is cooking rice, but my device can cook grains, okay, or it can cook all the grains. So you can write an apparatus for cooking grains. But if you think that my apparatus can also cook grains, rice, vegetables, and other foodstuffs, you can just use the word an apparatus for cooking. So you see how the things vary. So just for cooking grains, and then again, if it's a very broad, you just use the word cooking. Then comes the transition phase. Okay, so you have already defined an apparatus for cooking. Okay. Now there are two things that you can use, two words that you can use. It's either comprising or consisting of. So these are the two words that you can use. So one of the word is open-ended. So when you use when you are using the word comprising, you can go through these examples. So when you use the word comprising, it includes including, containing, characterized by, and so on. And examples would be an apparatus comprising a plurality of printed pages. So when you're using comprising, it includes a lot many things. Everything is included and beyond that. Okay. And when you're using the word consisting of, though the words seem quite familiar, but consisting of is a limiting term. So when you say consisting of a chemical compound consisting of this, this, and this, so there is no scope for adding a fourth component into this because already 100% has been achieved. All the components have been mentioned. So consisting of is a closed phrase. So we start the application like this, an apparatus for cooking, comprising of what? So then we go for the body of the claim. So body of the claim must recite elements and limitations of the claim. For example, an apparatus for holding items comprising at least one leg and a top configured to support at least one leg. So if you have you're devising a stand or something, so you can write an application for this. So an apparatus for holding items, this will be the preamble. Comprising will be the transition phase and the rest part will be the body of the claim. So all the claims are designed in the same fashion. So we will start with the case study that was sent to everyone on their WhatsApp number. So whoever WhatsApped me, they got the link for it, and hope you have studied it. So it's a discussion between basically a client and an inventor. So basically what happens, this inventor comes to the patent agent and he explains to him that, see, I have designed a bottle like this. So what this bottle basically is, as you can see from this diagram, I will just switch on annotation so that I can just mark something, a few things. So there's a cap. and there is a string, and then there is a lemon kind of a thing, and then there's a bottle or a container and a string. So basically what the inventor says that once he went to present an event or exhibition somewhere, so he saw this kind of a bottle. So what he did, he made his own bottle by this. So this is a milk bottle. So it's always difficult for mothers to carry the bottle and the baby food separately if they have to travel somewhere. So it's very difficult to carry the can and the bottle and the warm water, everything separately. So this is a bottle, you fill it with the water, warm water or whatever it is. Then there is a cap over here. The cap will contain a receptacle where you can fill the baby food into it, and you can put a cap over there. So once you put the cap, this becomes a closed assembly. And whenever you want to feed the child, you just open the cap, empty the contents into the bottle, close the thing, and the baby will be able to feed on this particular bottle. So by seeing this idea, he got another idea of patenting this particular invention, in which he said that there are various drinks that are available in the market, like fizz and all, and some contain flavor, some do not contain flavor, and all the flavor and the intensity of the flavor is not suitable for each and everyone. They're not customized. There are one taste fits all. Like if there's a Coca-Cola, it's the same flavor, same taste, same sugar level for everyone. So he said that I want to have a pouch kind of a thing, which is a lemon, artificial lemon kind of a thing. Hang it with the help of a string, attach the string to the cap and close the cap. So once you open the cap and pull the string out, you will be having this artificial lemon out in your hand, and you can squeeze the amount of lemon flavor or orange flavor or sugar, whatever is contained in this particular pouch, into your drink, and you can adjust the flavor according to you. So if you want to drink, you can drink it also. If you don't want to drink, you can throw it. And if you want to give it to someone else, you can also give it to someone else. So there's a lot of flexibility in this particular design. So this is how he made it. So cap, string, artificial lemon. So bottle has got an opening, and then there is a bottle over here. So string, lemon, he's squeezing it and the drops are falling into the bottle. And he also said that instead of the string has got a chance that it may break down, because when you're taking out, it's weak, so you can break. So either you can use a small metallic or some rod kind of a thing, or you can use a dental floss, which is much stronger to hang this particular thing. And this particular wedge, it need not be this shape. It could be in the form of a capsule or anything. It can also contain a sweetener or something. So this is what his invention was, basically. Then he, in the second step, he also describes how he is going to make this invention and all the things. So we'll restrict our discussion to the first part, basically. So this is the D1 prior art, which was explained. Then this is another prior art, a competitor person who has made a similar kind of an invention, but his particular thing does not hang inside. He has put a ring around the neck of the bottle, and this particular thing hangs outside the bottle. And then there is a capsule kind of a thing, which has to be broken down and the components have to be released into the contents. So quite similar, but not exactly similar. So at the end, I will want the audience to differentiate between the inventions. So this invention, which has got a string, a cap and a bottle, all those things. This particular invention, which has got a receptacle and everything. This particular thing where the lemon or the flavor is hanging outside the bottle. And then there is another one, another patent also he finds out from the literature, which says that there's someone who has made a similar kind of a thing. So he has taken this kind of a foam. So say 104 is a foam, and inside the foam there is a capsule kind of a thing, and this particular thing contains the flavor. So the flavor is trapped inside the foam. So because the diameter over here is very small and the diameter here is big, so because of the smaller diameter, the foam sticks to the capsule and it holds the particular thing over here. Once the person who wants to drink this opens the cap, he has to push this particular thing down with his finger. So he pushes it down. And once it goes down, because this is a foam, it's it absorbs water and it is permeable to the water. So the flavor is passed through this foam. So all this thing happens. So this is how the contents will be released in this thing. So basically he tells that his invention is a flavor drink, floating capsule dispenser. Dispensers can be removed, it is inside the bottle. and you can choose to release the components. And he describes the bottles. The bottle has got a small mouth, but the bottle can also have a big mouth. There's no problem with it. And if the string is there, but the string can also be a wire, it could be a dental floss, it could be a rod, it could be anything. And then he says that the if the bottle cap, if you open the bottle cap like the way you open the bottle of a cold drink, so when you like twist it like this, it's probable that the cap will get deformed and the wire or the thing will snap down. So he says that the cap can be the one shown in the diagram. It can also be a screw cap. So he says there is flexibility on the string part. There is flexibility on the cap portion. The mouth of the bottle container can be bigger or smaller. And he also says that that the dispenser can deliver varying concentrations. It's not necessary that the lemon flavor should be this percentage of water and this percentage of lemon. They can be different. And when it comes to cost, he says that he has got different methods of assembling the receptacle and the closure. So receptacle is basically the container we are talking about. And he's also flexible with the beverages. It's not necessary that the bottle or the container has only lemon juice or water. It can be alcoholic, it could be coffee, it could be tea, whatever it is. So he's free with that also. Then he says that in order to attach the cap with the string or the particular thing, he will be using an adhesive kind of a thing. Okay. And that it will be stuck inside. However, it can also be stuck outside. But there's a chance that it may be tampered. So if someone removes the attachment of the wire and the cap from the top, the wire will become less useful. Okay. And he says that to insert the dispenser and secure the cap by gluing the string to the cap, inserting the dispenser and then closing the cap. So this is how he wants to manufacture the thing. So the usefulness, he says that it's basically if you can eliminate sugar from the drinks, and if you can give the people a choice to whether they want to add the sugar or not, you can reduce obesity. Okay. And he also says that it's not necessary that the bottle will contain liquid always. He also plans to sell the bottle as such to other manufacturers, other companies who want to buy his bottle and use his patent for filling their drinks or their liquids into the bottle. So he's open in both the ways. That he wants to use it for his liquids also and for the liquids of others. So when I say that he is open to variations, okay, it means that the patent claim should not be limiting to it. The patent claim should be defined in such a way that there is scope for it. Okay. So whenever I'm saying the word he's open, there are variations, there is variety. It means that you need to go for a broader claim. So anywhere in the invention, anywhere in your technology, if you find that instead of this particular thing, I can use X, Y, Z and all those things, you need to tell the inventor, the patent agent, that these are the variable components. They are not very strictly assigned to this particular thing. And they are not very much crucial because they can be changed. However, I need a cap in the bottle, but I don't define that it cap should be a screw cap or should be a crown cap, you know, or it should be a rubber cork or something. So I just want a cap and cap can be anything. Okay. So you need to tell what are the same main features and what are the features which are less important or which can be changed. Okay. Now coming to this final diagram, and before we go ahead, I would request all the audience to draft a first claim for this particular invention. So we see that this is a kind of a container. Container has got a cap and a string and a liquid thing. And just by using these three or four things, I want the audience to define a first claim. And remember, the claim will have three different parts. It will have a preamble, it will have a transition phase, and it will have the body. So the preamble could be whatever you want to define it as, a bottle, container, receptacle, whatever you want to define it. Let us see how creative and how broad you can be in this particular thing. Okay. And then there will be a transition phase that will be either open-ended or closed-ended. Okay. So since there are a lot of varying factors in it, I would suggest that you go for an open-ended one, which means you go for comprising of. So you write the word comprising. A dash, it could be a bottle or whatever it is, a dash comprising of the following part comprising of A, B, C, and so on. Okay. So you need to identify what are the main things in this particular invention which you should be protecting. Okay. So will you be protecting the kind of cap, the string, the lemon, the flavor, the bottle, the design of the bottle? Okay. So what are the things that you feel are important from a patent point of view?
Amrish, Dr. Amrish, sorry for the interruption. There was one suggestion from Professor P.B. Sharma, Vice Chancellor of Amit University, Haryana.
Yes, sir. Nice to have their feedback, sir.
They are all observing. Vice Chancellor of Amit University, Jharkhand, Jai is observing. So many Vice Chancellors are there in your... so I'm so happy to see that they are also getting the knowledge. And, you know, he has put a very good idea, Professor B.B. Sharma, that why don't we give, better to give some high technology patenting case studies. This is okay for initially understanding.
Yes, sir.
Innovation. Can you also go from this level to a higher level of high technology patenting case studies relevant to today's COVID times and beyond for Industry 4.0?
So again, it's a very, very good suggestion, sir. No doubt about it. Absolutely welcome suggestion. Again, sir, when I talk of COVID, sir, COVID can be like there are people in artificial intelligence who are working on COVID. There are electronics working on COVID. There are medical devices, face shield, goggles, people who are working on COVID. Even photocatalyst and material science people are working on killing coronavirus. There are people on in healthcare sector who are working on medicines. Then there are people in biotechnology working on diagnostics. So what we plan is, what I can suggest is, sir, that if you agree and if everyone agrees, we can have different sessions stream-wise, like for electronics, for pharmacy, for biotech.
Dr. Murthy, Dr. Ambarish is very right. I was going to tell, for that we should have a third or fourth session where Dr. Ambarish very successfully demonstrated the high-end novel innovations. So I think he can prepare next time what you have been telling, all such high value innovations. I want one advice from Dr. Ambarish. Dr. Ambarish, one of my scientists has some idea.
Yes, sir.
And I tell them always, before you share these ideas with many people, you just file a provisional patent. Now, for filing a provisional patent, at least it should be so much that his idea is protected. But what else would be checked from the patent office before getting it filed? How much information one needs to give so that it is filed, it can be filed?
So the maximum possible data that an inventor is able to give on the date of filing is the more the beneficial it is. So even if he gives some extra data which is not useful later on, that is a welcome move, but he should not hold back some information which can be crucial.
Correct. So when we file the provisional patent, and within 1 year, you have to make it a complete patent. Otherwise,
exactly.
It's invalid. Now, can one give, within the time of, can one go on giving some further information during this duration of 1 year, or one needs to give it only one time during the duration of 1 year? Can the
scientist he can give it multiple times. So there's no issue with that.
Okay. Okay.
So even after 1 year, if he wants to add, a scientist is working on a particular technology. Right. So over a period of time, he will be improving his technology more and more. So every time he improves it, he does not need to file a new patent. He can file a patent for addition also, sir. Right. In that particular case, the government fees is need not be paid. So that is a lot of saving on the government fees part also.
Right. Now, before filing the provisional patent, a scientist has an idea, but he wants some advice before I put it on the paper and go to my patent office here in the MIT. Whose help he can take, his colleagues, his head of institution, or the help can be taken from the patent office people. Who are the best persons to advise him? Dr. Silvamurthy, P.V. Sharma, Rajiv Sharma, B.C. Das, because he wants somebody to show his text even before filing the provisional patent. Whose help is the most appropriate?
So there are different things. So the first thing is that he should do his own research, that is patent searching on a very thorough level.
Right.
Then he should come up with different questions and he should go to a patent agent and say whether these things are novel or not. Okay. So once he shares his abstract, not the full patent, not the data, but just an abstract of it, and he shows that this is what I'm working on and this is what I have found in the literature. Will it be patentable or not? So once he gets an idea of it without much disclosing of the patent, he can go to any committee which can keep the data confidential and he has faith on. He can discuss over there. And then depending on the decision of the committee, the further actions can be taken, sir.
Now, how far the patent agent will check his novelty? Because if he goes to the patent agent, he says, okay, this is sufficient to be filed as a problem. Because my idea is, whenever a scientist comes to me with the idea, I want within 24 hours to have a provisional patent filed within 24 hours. And this we have been doing. So now how deep the patent agent will see and say, novelty is not there, or maybe there, or is there. There are three alternatives. Patent agent will say novelty is not there at all, or you need to describe more to find a novelty, or there is sufficient novelty, we can file it as such. So how to go ahead with that?
So for the provisional patent, obviously, sir, someone asks me, I will not take more than an hour or two to find out whether the patent is basically on a cursory look, whether there's something novel in it or not. So it does not take very long time. Right. In-depth patent searching, obviously, it's a very time consuming. It requires a lot of effort. But on the cursory look of the first 10 patents using the correct keywords, you can give him an idea that, see, this diagram you are showing, this diagram is also over here. Let me know how this diagram is different from your diagram. Right. So these things can be given to an inventor in a very short time. And once he it finds it's okay, and if there are no financial constraints, he can obviously file a provisional application. There is no problem with that, sir.
When the patent agent goes deep in the matter and finds there is no novelty, then one can drop it.
One can drop it, sir.
Because actually the safest is that if the inventor is confident and there is a novelty, and even patent agent cannot give any specific advice, he should file it.
He should file, sir.
File it and try to do all experiments and testing and findings, and then support his invention. And then within 1 year, he can either sit, drop it, or make it complete.
Make it complete or drop it, or to go further as he wants to go further.
Dr. Simhamurthy, B.C. Das, P.V. Sharma, what do you say to that? Because I don't want, if there is an idea, Dr. V.K. Jain comes every fortnight with a wonderful idea. I tell, please keep shut, file a provisional patent. He has so great ideas.
Right.
So, V.K. Jain also from Haryana, everywhere, Chhattisgarh. So I want that as soon as inventor has the idea, he should rush to the patent agent. This is my provisional, please file it. And if he can't support it, let the money go waste. I don't mind.
I will share one of my experiences, sir. Like the Indo-Hungarian project that I and my wife, Dr. Seema Garg, working at Applied Sciences, we both share an Indo-Hungarian project. So it was a work on a material science basically, and we developed a photocatalyst. Now every time we used to share, we used to write that this particular material is patented, and it gave us a very good strength from inside to share the patent, because we knew that since it is patented, and even if somebody else steals it and works on it, he will be adding to our portfolio only and nothing else. So our patent will be getting stronger and stronger because of more literature coming into the science. So once you have a patent, once the scientist has a patent, he is very much free, he is very much confident, he is fearless in sharing his invention with n number of people. And only when he shares his patent with 10 people, 100 people, then there would be a likely chance of getting a collaboration or a funding or some kind of a selling or technology transfer. If he just keeps it to himself, thinking that he is very novel or something, then it will not get. So he needs to file a patent, and he needs to be very much vocal about his invention, that look, I have made this. And he can open it to the people, and he can get free feedback also from the people, whether this patent is workable or not, what are the lacunas, what can be improved into it. And since he already holds a provisional patent, he can always improve upon it. So any improvement will not bypass his provisional patent. So it's a very good move and a very visionary, sir, view, I would say, that everyone gets a chance to file a patent just at the concept level.
So, Amrish.
Dr. Smita Sahu, you, with the help of Simhamurthy, write to all my scientists. I've got a list now, all my scientists, technocrats, everywhere in my all universities, write an email, Silvamurthy will adapt it, that within 3 months, you give us any idea which you think is novel. So that within 3 months, I file a provisional patent for each of my person, maybe a GRF, SRF, Ramamur Swami, Ramanujam, everybody. So I don't mind if I have got crores or rupees spending in that, part of which goes waste. But at least one has a pressure on brain that in 3 months, I have to give idea. And if one does not have an idea, then he can join some other university. Because I need only innovative, creative scientists. So Dr. Sanovati, you wanted to say something.
Yeah, no, I totally agree with founder president. Idea is power and idea is money. Idea is wealth. So you preserve that. We in Amity, if you have a novel idea, provisional patent we file, as founder said, that within 24 hours we file the patent. So later you can work on that and convert that into CAP, that is complete after provision. So this is possible. So please send us all your ideas. Now the system is very fast. That's Smita Sahu and the team. Now Ramrish also will take his help. We will do it very fast, even less than half 24 hours we'll do it. And that this much, and then with a positive attitude to look at how do we get more patents. You know, because at some point of time you may convert within 1 year, you will do some experiments, proof of concept. We will develop a prototype, so we will give that facilitation also, not just we will stop with idea. Amity will give the environment, ecosystem, enabling mechanisms to convert this provisional into complete. So this also we will provide. So the message founder president has given very clearly that if you have some brilliant idea, novel idea, don't share with anybody else, first file the patent, so that you get the credit immediately, the priority, even at the idea stage itself, you get the credit.
Not anybody comes with the idea to me, I do not have a comfortable sleep till I get the doll information. It is provisionally filed.
I know that.
Every hour I'm comfortable that his idea may not be stolen by anybody, because you know people are also keeping ears and eyes open to steal an idea, and which I don't want. So that is why when you write to your people within 3 months, if somebody doesn't have any idea, then we will take care of that.
Actually, the worker, the scientist or an inventor, actually, if she or he works on the field, he has some clue that whether it is a new or not. Some preliminary clue he will have himself that it is something new I have found out. And since we have a in-house system, it's a unique system, and immediately you walk down to the next door and deposit your idea as an abstract. That's an excellent thing to have, that you can provisionally patent it, and then you can change it. Even it is also after 1 year, before 15 months, you can take it out, and then again you can resubmit. But your priority will be maintained. The original date will be maintained. So that is a unique thing, and I think what Founder President says, that it's an excellent thing to follow everybody. And we have also done, many other people are doing in the campus, they are just putting their the concept in the provisional patenting.
I want to also tell the viewers that you know Amity Founder President is spending crores of money on patents. Right from provisional to complete, then for RFE, we submit fees, then we submit fees for FER, then after granting the maintenance. So this is also important to have due diligence also, that first you create the idea, now look for it, preserve it, and convert that into complete if it is provisional. Make efforts, because it costs, everything costs money. If you see the number of patents, if you add, the money which he's spending in runs to crores. So we have to earn revenue out of that as well.
Dr. Ambrish, I must tell you why I am so obsessed. You all, my faculty members, if you go to the industry, you will get 4 times the salary. But you have a passion for academics and research. You don't go to industry, remain with me, and the salary which you are getting is, in comparison to industry, quite less. I was always thinking, how my scientists, faculty members can become rich because I can't make a very different cellular structure. I have to keep in line with the nuances in the education world. But the only way is that a scientist can earn as much as he likes, through patenting, because we have a legal system that 20% of his royalty will be given to scientist. If somebody pays one-time royalty, that at spot he will be given 20%, and we have generally one-time part of the royalty and then standing whole life. So I think all these scientists, those who are hearing, so you know, everybody needs money, and that gives you also self-esteem that I am earning so much money, if you need it or not, but that is a good idea. So Dr. Shivamurthy, I have got from yesterday, Dr. Sodhi, I'm grateful. You have sent me the list of each and every person from my all universities, those who are listening to the great deliberation of Dr. Ambarish. I am so convinced from yesterday and today. And today evening, I will have another list and I'll share with you. And all those who have been listening yesterday or today, they will be coming in my book of favorite scientists. And we should take care of them. Dr. B.C. Das, Dr. P.V. Sharma, my vice chancellor, Chhattisgarh. I think I have brilliant scientists, but now we have to ignite their brains. So Ambarish, or this lecture, I will only say that further, Dr. Sodhi, very important. I am opening this service of patenting for outside MIT people also. Well, many people come to me, sir, in our government body, it takes 6 months before we can think of filing a provisional patent. I told you, come to me, but you have to take one of my scientists as a co-inventor. Otherwise, I'll give you the service of 24 hours. So many people are contacting me with their ideas as they have become hopeless that their organization, private or government, can help him to file immediately. So that will be all thousands of persons to whom we will cater. Ambarish, your workload will increase. And Smita Sao is unbelievably competent. She is also load bearing. She will bear all the load. Dr. Shivamurthy, this idea we should follow immediately. Anybody who wants a patent, come to us.
Right. Okay. So viewers and MITians and those who are looking at dream to be rich, not only to generate knowledge, how do you convert that knowledge, Saraswati, into Lakshmi? You know, this is what Dr. Asim Chauhan mentioned yesterday, that you also think of Saraswati, you also think of Lakshmi. Here, Amity provides an opportunity. If you convert any patent into commercialization, either as a patent itself is commercialized, or you develop a product, technology, or a process, go into industry, 20%. If you get 1 crore, 20 lakhs goes to you. You know, 2 lakhs goes to you, 20 lakhs goes to you. This is what is systems which we have created, and this is being practiced. And whenever we have the technology transfer, at the time of receiving a check, we also give the check to the inventors as a simultaneously. So thank you, sir. And we will have more technologies going to industry. Now, so far about 15 technologies have reached industry. And let us hope that there'll be more innovations which will be reaching industry through Technology Enabling Center itself, and also through our Directorate of Innovation and Technology Transfer. Now, Ambarish, you can continue, but come to the crux of the problem and give the essentials and take it forward.
Right.
So we have already discussed the details of this application and everything. Now, if the...
You come closer to mic. Your voice is not very
audible. If the audience can just post in the first, very, very, very first claim that they want to draft. So I'm giving a hint. So it would something be like a container comprising of. So you need to write it further. So I will give you just a few seconds more to write it. Okay, so let us discuss the claims. I think it would be very new for everyone to actually be able to draft it for the first time. We need more practice. So it would be something like a container comprising. Now, a container is the preamble, comprising is a transition phase, and rest of the body that you see is the body of the claim. So here you need to see that the patent agent has used the word container. He has not used the word bottle or can or anything like that. because if you use a bottle, it has a different definite shape. It eliminates the container. And if you use a can has got again a different kind of a shape. But when you use a container, you are open for all the containers. So be it from a very small container, you know, size of your jewelry box, to as big as a tanker or a drum or anything. So the patent agent has used a very broad term, a container. Comprising, as you see, it's an open-ended term, and it's absolutely fine to use comprising. A receptacle having an opening. Now, a receptacle, he has not used again a bottle bottom or a rectangular bottom or a circular bottom. He has used the word receptacle. So receptacle could be anything. It could be a bottle. It could be a container, a drum, spherical, round, conical, whatever shape it is. So again, he has kept the things at a very broad thing. Having an opening. So when you put the word having an opening, it shows that there's an opening to it and it's not a closed container. Okay. So here, though he's limiting the things, but it's not required if you can put the word opening, or you can eliminate that also. But giving an indication that it has an opening is useful, because his invention will not be applicable if the container does not have an opening. So there's no point in hiding out or making it, just leaving it a receptacle. So he's used the word opening in exact context of his invention. A closure membrane irremovably mounted on the receptacle. Now you see he has not used the word cap. He has not used the word screw cap, crown cap, cork closure, a rubber closure or anything. He is saying a closure membrane irremovably mounted on the receptacle. Okay, so he's saying this is a closure membrane. So he's made the scope a lot wide, you know, on the receptacle and closing the opening. So this particular membrane will be closing the opening. So that's how he has defined the cap of the particular container or the bottle. Further, these things are very common, that having a receptacle with an opening. So there are many receptacles, many bottles, many containers with an opening. Again, they have many of them have a removable thing which is mounted on them. Now the crux of the invention is this particular line, which says a dispenser secured to the closure membrane. So he says that the dispenser or the string or the rod, whatever it is secured to the closure membrane, and it is housed or kept inside the receptacle. Okay, the dispenser configured for withdrawal. Further, he's saying the same claim, that the dispenser is made in such a way that it can be withdrawn through the opening by removing the closure membrane from the receptacle. So you see how the invention was, how the first claim we say is the independent claim. The first claim is the claim which is the most important one, and rest of the claims are further dependent on these particular claim. So in the further claims, he will be explaining how the receptacle is, what kind of a opening it is, what kind of a closure membrane it is, dispenser, what type of dispenser it is, you know, how to withdraw it and how to close it and all those things. Okay. So you see the terms that you use: container, receptacle, opening, closure membrane, dispenser. So in this particular, he has used dispenser. He has not used a thread, a floss, a wire. He has not used any of the terms. He has just used a very unique term, which is called as dispenser, which will be used commonly for all the things which are used to dispense or hang something. So this is how the patents are claims are drafted, and how you make it a very strong patent with a broad scope, and still you limit the things so that you have the novelty in the claim. So if you just put the first two points in it, there won't be any novelty in it. So because there are many receptacles with that have closure, they have that opening, but this particular third point in the first claim itself makes the invention novel in its entirety or entire perspective. So going further down, you will have different so preamble, receptacle and other things. So we'll not go deep into various claims kind of a thing. So this will be for some other day. Further, there are two things in this particular patent. One is the bottle, the dispenser system itself, and the other one is the way in which he's putting it. So the first claim, if you remember, it contains a container comprising. Okay. And in the eighth claim, or the second independent claim, he's saying a method of assembling. So a single patent can have two or more things if they are related to the same invention. So the inventor wants to claim both the things. One, the dispenser assembly, and also the method of assembling the same. So the method of assembling includes securing the dispenser to the closure membrane. So he's attaching the wire or the thread to the closure membrane to the cap. inserting the dispenser into the receptacle, so putting the dispenser into the container via an opening in the receptacle and closing the opening with the secure membrane, closure membrane. So again, he has said that this is the how he is going to make it. He is not going to stick the dispenser outside. He is not going to hang the dispenser outside, because we saw that in D2, the particular lemon wedge was hung outside the bottle. So if you don't use this thing, that it is inside the container, inserting and all these things, it will be failing. Okay. And then finally closing the things. Again, if you don't use the word inserting the dispenser via the receptacle, then again, you see in D3, you saw that there was a foam, and inside the foam, the lemon was kept. The lemon juice was kept. Okay. So you need to draft a claim which will not infringe the earlier patents also, and which will protect your particular inventor also. So these are the intricacies that need to be worked into when you are drafting a claim. So whenever next time when you see a claim for yourself or you read a patent application, so you will be able to see, find out which are the independent claims and see what are the main features of that patent. So within a few minutes, you will be able to get the crux of the patent, what this particular patent says, without going through the 40-50 page document. So these are again descriptions of the various things that we have. Okay, not to be going deep into it. So you can write an abstract depending on what you have studied. So a container is provided that includes receptacle, a closure membrane, a dispenser. The receptacle can be in the form of a beverage bottle and can house a substance. Now let me tell you, the abstract is not the legal binding. Okay, so here he has used all those common things, like a bottle he has used. Okay, and you can use those common words that are used. The closure membrane can be in the form of a lid and closes the opening. The dispenser is both secured to the closure membrane and housed within the receptacle. The dispenser can be removed from the receptacle by removing the closure membrane. This allows for safe storage of dispenser while allowing the readiness and remove the dispenser or the receptacle for use. Now in this entire patent, you see claim thing, you see the application or use, that the people will be able to vary the concentration of the lemon juice. They will be able to use it or throw it. So all those technical, non-technical things have been completely eliminated. Though those were the motivations for the inventor to start working on this invention, but as such, they do not hold any legal ground. So all those story kind of things, they were entirely removed from the abstract and the claim parts. So this is basically common. So title can be given a container and method of assembling the container. So since this container, description of the container and method also, so we can put both the things. Again, let me tell you, the title is not a legally binding thing. So titles can be as per your desire. So this is not much, but it should be relevant to the patent which is being filed. Then you have field of invention, background, D1, D2, those things. So I thank you for everyone having your valuable time and having your valuable presence in this particular event.
Very good. Amrish, you have done a wonderful job. You have brought every aspect, and now you will be available for any consultation also on this from the viewers, because there are so many questions, so many comments, so many thank you, and so many applause for your presentation and the way you have presented this whole concept of how do we make plane, which is very vital for a patent. And also yesterday, the orientation, how to be innovative? How do you think to be an innovator? And how you can bring change, look for the necessity, look for the need, and then ultimately address the issue, find a new solution, then you can file a patent. And today, founder president has also given the committee's view on patent, patenting, and commercialization.
Given a mandate, Dr. Given a mandate.
Yes.
Yes, sir. So salute to you, sir, for your visionary input, sir.
Dr. Sorry, just to interrupt you, if there are some questions which, because of time paucity, could not be attended, can you read out just the questions so that we know the thinking in the brain of my scientist? Are there some questions which you can just read the question and the name of the person, right, and no reply at the moment? That will be given by in the next 4 session.
Yes, I'll start with Utkarsh Saxena. Right. Which search engine is better for patent searching, WIPO or Google Patents? another question. Patent can, then this is Beja Gam Harini. Patent can be used by anyone, or it can be used only by the patent holder. Then another question is single family member, family number combines an application. So patents applied globally have same number, or it will be different, national and global, is it different numbers will be given. Then Utkarsh Saxena is asking, what is the process of patent commercialization? Then another anonymous attendee, thank you for your valuable talk, sir. What is the main difference between a work that is novel and the one that can be patented? Most traditional usage products don't have exact reasons or mechanisms behind the activity. If exact component responsible for activity is discovered, will it be patentable? Then he is again asking, is patent filing in India different from other countries? Then Nutan Kaushik, WIPO contains only PCT, are all patent files? That was another question. Nutan also is asking, WIPO site has only PCT files or patent? Here she has just repeated. Mr. Tungri Goshal is asking, how about patent applications that have not been published or have not completed 18 months from date of filing? How do we see that? Which are the ones filed but not published yet? Then can we transfer patent from one company to other? Then Sunita Sisla, can an expedited examination application be applied online under this act? Then Mr. Tungri is asking, after patenting, am I always to submit Form 27 to the controller? If I don't have a freedom to operate, what use will my patent be? Then Pavan Porwal, how to construct a good claim? Then Kirti Rani, thanks, sir. What is the use of WIPO per exact sense to see patents rights in 10 different languages? Then Sonia Gupta, will this site also give us information about copyright regarding design process and others? He's asking about the site. Then Utkarsh again is asking, can you share how to draft patent claims? Then Sudipta Saha, Dr. Sudipta Saha is asking, my patent number is, he has given the number 264556, was applied and granted from CSIR IICB, Indian Institute of Chemical Biology, along with my mentors. Can I do anything with it from Amity? That is, it was filed there in CSIR lab, but can I do anything with it from Amity? Then Sridhar from AUH, for patenting, an engineering product should be include the complete dimension in the drawings, or you can just have the design. Then Sanjay Sharma, if an existing product is developed at lower price, the same can be patented or not? Because it's only cost reduction. Can that be eligible for patenting? Dr. Sudipta Saha is one more question. Nothing was done from IICB to market it. And I was also not allowed to do anything. And I was told it is CSIR property. So now he's asking whether Amity can do anything with that patent. Then Raman Jha, our VC from Amity University, Jharkhand, how to patent your idea without any product? The next one is Mr. Banerjee, that is Swobrota Banerjee, can we get this PPT? Then Dr. Jaspal Kandari, can you suggest patent tools for social science and humanities? Then Jitendra Tanwar, is there any limit of patent of persons that can associate with one patent? So is there any limit that only 100, 200, 500? Vandana Chauhan is asking, only concept can be protected by IP rights? If no, then wet lab data is possible in 18 months for filing complete patent. How to protect the idea? Then another anonymous attendee, can we patent business ideas? The other one is Manjula Vij, is asking, can an idea be patented? So Foundry has amply clarified on that. Please bring that idea. If it is novel, immediately we'll file it. Then Archana Kumar, shall we shall we or can we do the filing of a patent with idea which is contributed by me and one non-Amitian student? So one student from Amity is asking if there is another non-Amitian student, can we combined way file a patent? Then yes. Then Babar Ali, is there any certificate to attend this session? So can we give e-certificate to attend this session? Yes, I think it is worthwhile. We have the list, and certainly Smita and Amrish, please ensure that we give e-certificate to every one of the participants who attended yesterday and today, and we will provide e-certificate. And that will also help you, and you build on this foundation and the orientation further. We will be organizing more lectures because this is only a beginning. Now we will know how to translate them, how do we commercialize. So there'll be series of activity from TEC. So I would request Dr. Dilip to continue this activity so that right from mine to market, lab to land, how do we take it? Now only IPR you have dealt with and little on innovation. Now we will take it forward. Then Alok Singh, for filing a provisional patent, how much experimental data do we need? Can only idea be used for filing the provisional patent? Yes, it has been answered amply by founder president. Are there any weightage difference among patent filing from different countries? Then Dr. Sweta Siddharth, can a financial product suitable to rural population be patented? Can a new financial product suitable to rural population be patented? Yes. Is software, or for that, this Chandradeep Tandon is asking, is software, or for that matter, methods of doing business, or mathematical methods, or computer programs, as such, are patentable or not? So he is putting a question. Then Dr. Parul is asking, how patent can be utilized in case of humanities? Then Sohini Singh, can we now add scientists of other institute also in patenting? Yes, you can. We have already done it. We have done it in Amity, number of patents, but we only want concrete contributions. How much is that from that institution or that individual should be given? But the patent is assigned to Amity. But the inventor will be shown from that institution also. If there is a commercialization, sharing will also happen along with that individual as well. Then Sohini Singh, can we add scientists from other institute? I have answered. Then Yasin Sirdara, we need a session to understand how software can be included in electronic hardware and its patent claim. So if you have a hardware and you are adding a software embedded into the hardware, then how do we patent claim that? It's a very good question. Now, Devika Unitan, can we patent an idea which still needs an insight for developing a software or tool? Then Dr. Neetu Saxena, sir, can a simple thing such as electric sequence lights be patented? Then Rohit Tomer, sir, I request you to guide us regarding copyrights, because you have talked more about patent, how to file copyright and the fees for that, etc. It is 500 rupees and copyrights are filed very fast. And please do, if you have details of your copyright to be filed, immediately contact Dr. Smita Sahu, who is now the chief of all the IPR. And she will be able to guide you on the copyright. Yes, copyright can be filed. Dr. S. Parul, how copyright is different from patent? Then Snail Tandon, that is Sahil Tandon, can the decision to grant a patent be challenged? Can the decision to grant a patent be challenged? Yes, if you have some proof that you already is open knowledge or all that, this is possible. Then Vinamra Sharma, new combination of traditional drugs with a new indication, can it be patented? Thanks. Then Dr. Sarmita Ray, can access www.vipo.int? Then he's asking that. Then Ruchika Batla, how do we get funding for our filed patent to convert it into technology? Yes, if you have filed and it has a commercial value, we will enable. Now the Technology Enabling Center also is now supporting to a minimal amount if it is required. If the ideas are good, we will support you in some form. But bring good ideas. We will find the resources. There are many schemes from BIRAC and also the SERB, R&D, the industry-related R&D. Number of schemes are also available. But certainly we will find a method for translation into a product. Then Ruchika Batla, how do we, that's I have spoken. Then Mr. Samyak Nag, which one is wise move? Is it filing conventional application or international application and why? So if it has got an international ramification, your product is global, and after filing the national patent, the conventional application, you can go for PCT, which will give cover for some years. And then within that period, you can also file in specific countries. Then Samyak Nag, how often patent classification codes used over keyword for patent search? Then Samyak Nag, again, another question, what are different databases or tools available for different patent mapping? Then Sarmista Ray, based on the topic nanoparticle synthesis and antimicrobial activity, but can the IT classification be different? Because I checked my three patents have different IT classification, IT BP, BB2Y5/00, IT A61K8/04, and other is CD9C1/62. So specifically she is asking a question. Now, Ruchika Patla, how do we get funding for our filed patent to this? I have already answered. So these are some of the, and now my patent is already filed through our Amity Patent Office. How do we get funding for our patent file? This I have already answered. And many more have come in the chat box. These are on the QA box. And I find a number of chat box also, number of questions are there, sir. And these are specifically from QA box I have read.
Absolutely, very good. I think I'm proud on my all scientists or technocrats, technologists, those who have asked these questions. Really, these are very valid, very interesting questions. So what we do now, you kindly pass on these questions to Smita Sahu and Amrish.
Yes.
And they will reply per email.
Yes.
Each question is worth replying, and send me a copy of the question, who has asked it, and the reply.
Yes.
That is one thing, because you know they all have eagerly put a question to get the answer today, but then we would have sat till midnight if we start answering all questions. So all my question answering persons, you will get shortly, within next days, the reply to your question. And you can always also take control of Smita Sahu and Abrish to further get clarification.
Sir, one humble submission, sir. We can create a web page and put all the FAQs on that site, so others can also benefit, and the whole of India can benefit by that.
Good idea.
Because these are common questions everybody asks every time. So we can create a web page with your kind permission, and we can put the answers over there.
Good idea, Dr. Swamurthy. Dr. DC Das, PB Sharma, you please consider. Dr. R.K. Padhyay, please consider all this idea. So one thing more, Dr. Swamurthy.
Yes, sir.
Now I put you in a awkward position.
till now, the
patents which are, we have filed 1285.
Yes.
Now we have ended June. It means half a year of 220. Now by December 31st, 220, what target we should have after this today's session, where I'm getting within 3 months an idea from each one of my thousands of people, those who are scientists or technologists in my universities. So we will be having bombarding from ideas. And I am now giving to Smita Sahu a team of 20 competent persons, those who can find the idea and file the provisional and then go for the helping in making filing the complete. So Smita, you will be getting soon. Yesterday I got 1 feet high US, you must have got it all about the WIPO publications, which institutions in the country. So, Smita, did you see? I don't know if Smita is on mic or not. So,
Smita, are you there? Can we take Smita, Dr. Sodhi? Our IT department, can we just take Smita Sahu also on the panel if she's not?
Let me check.
Sir. In the meantime, Dr. Sanamurthy.
Yes, sir.
I am very demanding to ask my creative scientist. When I was in West Germany, head of the research and development department, I told to my people, develop a tablet. If somebody is in a hurry to go to office, could not take breakfast, develop a tablet that he takes it and it cleans the teeth. It cleans the teeth. And if your sugar, blood glucose value is down, that 2-3 hours, that has no problem. And 2-3 hours, you don't have hunger till you find an office to have your sandwich. So
a really, very novel innovation.
You're working on it. And then I'm developing a fragrance of a perfume, which we'll spray in our campus. And that fragrance means this campus is a campus of motivation. We're working on it. Because you know, these are crazy ideas, but all big developments have taken from the crazy ideas. So, and I've got
Absolutely.
So many people. So, is Smita online now? Anyhow, that's not the idea.
Dr. Smita Sahu is not in the session right now. She is in the tent office.
Okay, no problem. So, my idea is that...
Sir, I have tried contacting Smita Sahu. She will soon join.
No problem.
She's trying to join.
She has... I have read yesterday, I told you, 1 foot high printout. Because I want to know all over the world who is running the courses of patents and patent agents and all. And I want to start immediately these programs.
Yes.
Amrish, you also keep in mind, I want to prepare, because to every university, I want to send 4 or 5 people, those who are sitting there and talking to the scientists. It's very important, the hand holding of my scientists and technologists, so that the results are fast. So this all concept, Dr. Sanamurthy, you make, how we control the helping the people from all our universities. And therefore, anybody, if you know some patent experts, tell to Smita Sahu, so that we can consider appointing such persons in our, I got only 3-4 biodata sent by her.
Right.
When I have already appointed Harish Sharma.
Yes.
And the idea is that, Dr. Sanamurthy, to become the biggest in science and innovation in the country and globally, we need really challenging. So now, in the meantime, you must have thought, what number you will give? 1285 is now.
Yes, and we will add 500 more for the next 500 more.
Great.
So it's a big target, 500 more in 6 months.
No, I'll say that's in 12 months.
12 months, okay.
I have a good sleep. So 12 months. 500 more, at least, you know, you can shoot the target.
Right.
So now everybody has listened it. So Dr. Sanamurthy has always achieved what he has told, always. My vice chancellor hearing it, we need help from each vice chancellor. 500 more patents, at least 500 within next 12 months. It means till 30th June 2021. Okay.
Yes, we will achieve, sir. Once you have set the target, we will turn mountains and achieve that, and it will happen. That is what we have already demonstrated. All Amitians have that commitment, and right. They work with vision board. Once they commit, it happens, whether it is for publication, the targets which we have set for all campuses with their participation, with their own drive, it is happening. And this will also happen. I can assure you that this 500 in the next 12 months will happen. Thank you so much.
Dr. Amrish, you are the culprit. You have made this ignition, make these big problems to everybody. Now many would not sleep comfortably that they have to fulfill this 500 target, which is not very difficult. Dr. Sanamurthy has been achieving everything with Dr. B.C. Das, Dr. P.V. Sharma, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Uttan Kaushik, and my Dr. R.K. Pandey. So I think today's conclusion was extremely valuable. And Dr. Amrish, please also help everybody. So I thank to everybody.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for joining us. And I would request Dr. B.C. Das, who is the chief coordinator of the TEC. Yesterday he couldn't speak. So I would request him to make a brief remarks. And he has really taken a lot of interest to see that technology enabling center bubbles with energy, and he's pushing. And with all that will happen, and also all vice chancellors who are listening, and also all participants, please, this 500 is your target, is our target. So we must at any cost achieve this. Now we will divide looking at the patterns, that how you have been filing patent, and we will send you a target to each one of you, that how we can divide this 500 into our universities. And please, you also reflect on that and say that what is the target after your approval, then we will put that as the target for you, for your university. And so thank you very much, sir, for this. Now I would request Dr. B.C. Das to say a few words.
Thank you, Dr. Selvamurthy. And it is with the blessings and what started several years back. Yesterday it was told also that when no other university or organization are thinking of doing the patenting or innovation or anything, that was only our honorable founder president who thought of this. And I know he is a great thinker and a visionary, and that has made all the difference. And that is why we are at this stage when we are competing, we are surpassing others and nobody is touching us. And I think what he has given the task, that 500 in 1 year, it's we are achieving as per his expectation and mission, and we will meet his mission, and that will touch the also the national mission. And and the TEC, what is has been started with his blessing, initially there was some hitch, and he wanted to understand rightly how we are going. And he is always, what we cannot think of, he goes beyond that. So that is how what happened, and now it is in a real strong footing, and it has taken the right speed, and it will go on. Even within the lockdown period, it has gained a lot of good spirit, and it is the speed and spirit. And it is in the beginning that the first workshop is really wonderful, that yesterday you were more than 600, and today more than 500, touching the 600 almost. So I was little worried in the beginning that how many people will come, but then it's really changed the complete idea, and it shows that how the people of our MITians and outside also, they are interested. And what our founder president mentioned, that we'll allow the outsider, and the same question comes from the audience, the similar question asked, that whether we can file the patent in MIT and take part in the MITs. But it is right that our one person or someone would be the partner to that patenting. Otherwise, what is the interest of the MIT? So MIT's interest to be paramount. And all the credit and thanks goes to our founder president. And it was also yesterday, I could not speak. And yesterday I was in the campus for 3-4 hours, and I was connecting from the campus in the MIT campus, because there are some urgent work I had to go, because the lab, the deep freezers and other things was breaking down. So it was because there are more than 28 projects running, around 25 crores project. So I am worried that the results and the progress report has to be submitted. Otherwise, we cannot get the money in the next session. So it was a restless condition. So I ran to the yesterday for 3 hours, and I was connecting from there. So I was, all these things are in disarray. I was not able to connect in the beginning. And so I missed in the beginning. So, I could connect after all, and I could listen. So many thanks for the all the our the audience, and the our mainly the TEC workers, all including the our Dr. Upadhyay, and of course above all Dr. Selvamurthy, who has been the guiding force. And when there is no founder's presence, we always feel in absence also we are always inspired. But then in his absence, always Dr. Selvamurthy is there to tell us, go ahead with this thing and do this thing and all. So it's an excellent group now I have built up, and I think what founder's vision we'll be able to achieve. And we are really his soldiers, dedicated soldiers rather, and we will be able to achieve all this, what is he has visioned or what is his mission. Thank you so much for giving an opportunity to speak, and all the audience, please, you have listened to the great talk by founder yesterday, and the two vice chancellor, two chancellor of our AUUP and AUG, and what exciting talk they gave. And it's really very exciting and really very inspiring talks that have, and those who have listened to it, I think they have got an idea how to go about it. And this really, I feel really very fortunate to listen to those talks. It is all these words coming from the heart. And those who can see it, they can really feel it, and they cannot miss it to do things to the extent possible we can go. Thank you so much, sir. And thank you all of us. And thanks lastly also, Dr. Ramesh, Amrish Chandra. So you are in my Health and Allied Sciences professor there in the AIP. I was knowing that you are.
But how long now in Health and Allied Sciences, MIT Institute of Pharmacy? How long would I leave him there? Because maybe we kidnap him for our patent establishment.
Yes, yes. He may be. Yeah, you are very right, sir. He may be put in some right job, and it is you to take decision. So he can do much better things. So it is up to your decision. I think he has right knowledge, and he can be of use of in this field.
One question to you. What is it in your institution, AIMLSR, that such brilliant scientists, Ramalingam Swami, Ramalujam, and DST Inspire, for example, if you take Subrajit Vishwas, you rang me 10 days back, that he wants to come. He was the first request to come to the campus and work in his lab. I told yes at them. Dr. Subrajit held on 30th of June a marathon meeting of all HOIs, and you people have decided and put forward this to the chancellor that scientists are feeling unrestful without their lab. Today I'll speak to chancellor and I'll let you know what is the situation, but it is a great motivation for all of us that our scientists and technologists are feeling unrestful without this lab. So I think we'll find some solution. Maybe 3 days, one group can come, another 2 days, three, another group can come, so that we keep the rules and regulations, but also my scientists can do the work on the labs.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Grateful for this. Everyone, every scientist faculty is bubbling now.
Very restless.
Thank you so much. You have made the day for every one of us.
Thank you so much.
And Amrish, so you have a big role now, besides being a pharmacist, faculty in pharmacist. I think now you have a bigger role. Founder is envisaging for you. And certainly you can make some big contribution to Amity Group. Not only Amity University Uttar Pradesh Noida, but Amity Group. That is the broad role now founder is now hinting at, and I'm sure you will excel. The way you have conducted this, the knowledge, the depth, and also the breadth of your knowledge in IPR is very good. And where we want to strengthen this, not only that, now commercialization, now Dr. Dilip Upadhyaya and your team now has to, the whole patent has been categorized into three. Yeah. Now please come out maybe by tomorrow, a report to founder president that what all we are doing on that categorization which Smita had sent to you.
Yes.
That ultimately now we should see the product going to industry. Now we would like to listen from you maybe briefly 2 minutes.
Yes, sir.
please.
Smita Sahu has joined. Professor Smita Sahu has joined, sir.
Before we close, a word of appreciation for Mr. Amol Chauhan,
yes, sir,
who is now my executive director, strategic operations at FPO. He's so brilliant. I don't take any decision or make any opinion without his advice. Not only that he has studied in Harvard, but he has so brilliant leadership. So he's always helping me at my side so that everything goes smooth in the webinar. Amol?
Can we see him on the screen for a few messages for all of us, Mr. Amolji? Please, we want to see you, and every one of the listeners, participants would like to have your thoughts, maybe for a couple of minutes. Over to you, Mr. Amolji.
Sir, he's very hesitant, so I think he's sitting near me. But he told, no,
thank you so much. You always help founder president, and you are blessed to be with him all the time.
Good. Now, Dilip Upadhyay.
Are you asking anything to me?
Your question was, what is in you that you have such a jamgad of such brilliant scientists from all over the country and also overseas? What is this in you?
Very difficult.
Vishidas, don't hesitate. Tell us the secret.
Secret of, sir, I am sorry, sir. I was with the other.
My question was,
sir,
what is the thing in your institution, molecular science and cancer research, AIMSSR, that so many brilliant scientists, Ramchandran Swami, Ramanujan fellow, DST Inspire fellow, they all, it is jamgad at your place. They all want to come to you. What is this in you as a leader of the institution? What is this?
So that I cannot say, sir. It is only they know. So it is. I am also very happy that it is increasing day by day. And everybody, when they see my biodata, Dr. Selvamurthy knows in the interview, they say, we have seen it. And Dr. Vishidas is there, so I will join. So I will certainly join. So it is like that. There are 3-4 are on the line. Right. So one is in the Delhi itself, and another from VIT. He is leaving VIT and coming here.
Right.
And the Meenakshi Munshi asked her, why you are going to leave the VIT, famous institute, in Vellore, and you want to come to MIT. No, I will join MIT because there is a great scientist there. I will have mentorship, and I want to join there. And MIT and this institute has a lot of facility and a lot of freedom, and it's really I can do some science there. So
let me further supplement, sir, what you said.
Yes, sir.
First is Amity's image, the brand which you have created today for research and innovation, the ecosystem, that aura. First, they look at the aura, the message spreads that how the ecosystem is there. So first credit goes to you that you are, Amity is able to attract such brilliant. Second is this, his image, his credentials, he's fellow of all the 3 academies.
Right.
And he is known globally in the field of molecular medicine and also the HPV, that is human papilloma virus. He is the father of this, who brought that concept of HPV for cancer cervix to our country. Right. So such credentials, when they look at the profile of the faculties available, so he stands out. So like a magnet, which attracts.
Type of faculty, their credential, and the MIT's brand. So that attracts, and our existing faculty and Ramalinga Swami fellows, they act as an ambassador also.
Yes.
They get the input from them, and they also, they say that it is excellent. It is your own house. You come and do research what you want, and you can prosper, right? So that makes them excited, and they come and join.
So the kind of profile of faculties today in all campuses now, We are able to see the quality has exponentially grown in terms of the capable, skilled, knowledgeable, competent, self-motivated people who are coming. That number is growing. So that is the great strength. It is the
people. And one lesson I have got it from you, sir. I have learned in the last phase of my career from none other than founder president, sir, that you have to know the persons. Means you have to just identify the real person, not that quality of the publication or not, but you have to really identify a good person. They then only you, and that is why I am successful perhaps, and I keep a freedom and very democratic situation in the department. So everybody can anytime just walk down and talk friendly and discuss things. Anybody, there is no inhibition that anybody can come and discuss, not like any as a director or a head, some barrier, there is no barrier at all.
Right. Dr. Smita has joined, sir.
Smita, I was looking for you. There were the large number of questions, very valuable and very appropriate questions. So I have requested that they should be all sent to Amrish and to you, and you both sit together and make the replies to send on email, and a copy would be sent to me and Dr. Ramamurthy, because these were so appropriate questions. Even I would be eager to know the reply of many. So Smita, and I told that I am going to give you 20 persons. So be ready. You are already very hardworking, and you have not broken down with whatever workload you had. So I have more faith that you will not break down with the further load.
Sir, I'm really sorry for the inconvenience, sir, because we had urgent office actions, because yes. Controller wants few affidavits to be submitted immediately for approval of the grant. So I was working on that. And sir, another target which I have given to myself is every day to clear one or two fresh application, reply on the complete, that's complete after provisional, and also to response to FER, to so that I can give a little message to assurance to our inventors that their backlog will be gradually, sir, taken care of with.
Great.
And also Dr. Smita, founder has given, we have already accepted a target of 500 in 12 months. So it's for us to achieve it. You will achieve it. We will achieve it.
Sir, I would like to add here that really, I'm so grateful to Dr. Amrish Ji with such an excellent deliberation. And I feel so strengthened, sir. Eventually, it will help self-reliance, and it will help us to make a sustainable, inclusive IP innovation ecosystem very soon at Amity University. And we assure you, sir, founder, sir, towards contributing immensely to realize your mission, mandate, and vision, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Dr. Naved, Dr. Kulkarni, you have seen my alert to you both. You must, if you are not on the line, somebody will tell you what is this alert for your institution that I want to kidnap Amrish.
Now the decision is made. It's going to be only implemented.
I hope TEC is not blamed for that.
also, because you are really commercializing very fast. So having you at the helm of the affairs, I think my commercialization will go very fast, Dr. Dilip Upadhyay.
Yes, sir.
I'm
really thankful, and I'm really impressed the way founder sir has come and really graced this occasion for 2 days. I'm sincerely telling you, in my past experience, I've never seen any chief of the institute really giving so much time. And that's what I today understood in my tenure at Amity, that really why Amity is going so strong, and really in this competitive environment, it is surviving. I'm telling you from my heart. And I'm really thankful to Dr. Salvamurthy that he really pushed us to do this kind of training program, because we were only doing one track, but I understood that this training program is going to really give us access to multiple of our universities and some of the industries, you know, all small scale clusters. Now they understood our potential through this, and this is going to really give us a boost in our future. So I'm really thankful to all of them, including Dr. Chandra for his really readiness and...
Thank you. Sir, shall we close it, sir?
Yes, please. Okay, I think my compliment and blessings and appreciation to everybody. You know, you are different, distinguished scientists at my group, and I will keep you in eye. This will help you in your professional progress at MIT, because we have a CCSM factor, competence, commitment, and self-motivation. So all those who have attended, they will be getting a higher CCSM factor than their colleagues. And I am really very appreciative. Dr. Salvamurthy, you are unparalleled, unbelieved, unmatched. Without you, no webinar.
Your blessings. It is your energy. I just draw some energy like a Paramatma, Jeevatma. I draw that from Paramatma.
Dr. Ramamurthy, when chairperson heard she was busy in the other meeting, she ran to tell you one thing. She wants your help. She has brilliant students, those who are able to file patents.
Right.
Chairperson, can you tell yourself to Dr. Ramamurthy? Just tell it from there.
Dr. Ramamurthy, very, very good afternoon. The founder rightly said about you.
Yes,
you
madam.
Unbelievable. So my question was, discussing the founder, we have got very bright and innovative children in our school.
Yes.
Some of them, they want to do intern with the scientists or with the professors. They want to do intern. Like 2 years back, we had a boy in our Sake school, and he wanted to do intern with Amity University. But yes, at time I never thought how should I proceed. But then he took the internship in the foreign university. So I want that the children who are interested doing intern in Amity in any field, they should do in Amity University only.
Yes, so madam.
How to proceed it?
Contact Dr. Rajiv Sharma. Rajiv Sharma is the link between higher education and school. Just tell to Rajiv Sharma, then he will make it all
any,
possible.
Any field, whether it is special training, whether it is animation, science, anything.
So we are, madam, it's a brilliant idea. Well, see, Amity is one family, right? Yes. From pre-nursery to postdoc, this whole Amity group is one family. So the schools are part of Amity. So this university is yours.
Like in China, in the Beijing University, there was a child, the school child was doing work in the lab.
Right.
So I asked what the school child is doing here. So he said, doing the project work in the university. He's an intern in Peking University.
No, we will groom them like what we have done for space program, MS Prasad, we interfaced. So like that, our students, whenever they, after finishing the school, they can come and work in the late in the afternoon,
the holidays.
So we will certainly make it happen, madam, in larger number, even though now that interface is there.
I'll send the circular in the school now.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
And we will also make Rajiv Sharma solely responsible to be the interface with the school. And then I will implement them at the university level, interfacing with them, and we will provide all support to our Amity International School and Global School students. It will be done.
Thank you so much.
Sir, this is Dilip here. We have done that immunology day, and today we got the school children from Amity, and we taught them what is immunology. We took them to the lab and did the blood grouping and antibody antigen testing. So that can be done in a bigger way. But in last year, immunology day, we have done this.
Because many of the students may like to join our university. After getting the flavor of it, they will speak about the university, and then from Amity school, they will come to Amity University.
So we take interns from outside, but their school children can come. Those who are interested from 9 to 10 and 11 or 12 classes, they can come anytime, and summer vacation, they can join in a lab under a professor, and they can do some project. So that is what internship, they can spend 4 weeks, 6 weeks, their vacation time. And that would be easily feasible to do it in the university campus.
We will do it, madam. We'll do it with full focus.
Dr. Ramamurthy, yesterday I mentioned, but this is such an information I want to repeat today. Dr. Group Captain Shukla wrote about what Rajendra Prasad told us, the science leaders workshop.
Yes.
And within short notice, 2,200 people from my universities attended the workshop. 2,200 from all universities. And 799 gave the test and examination. And a large number of people, Shefali Kashyap and Vinay Chauhan, got something more than 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10. And I have got all lists before me of 779. They will be your favorite people, Dr. Ramamurthy.
That is Amity.
Astonishing. The exams were very difficult. I have got the paper of the examination. Even I will have difficulty in replying some questions. Very tactful questions. But in learning, we will get this question paper. I've got it from my different scientists.
Right.
And get to send it to all my scientists. Yes. There is a lot of learning in that. So yes. I compliment Guru Shukla for your day and night efforts. I was afraid you may not break down, but you did not. And it is surprising. 2,200 attending the workshop. Okay, thank you.
And yesterday you had sent that program of INSA.
Right,
Rajendra
right.
Prasad had sent. We have already communicated last night itself. Right, that is the right. You sent it around 6:45 in the evening. So right. We have sent it right 11 o'clock. The messages right. have gone, and then people will be watching today.
Great.
So yesterday itself, it has been communicated to all campuses with regard to INSA program, right. where Dr. Soumya Swaminathan
yes.
and many Balram Bhargava, many people are attending.
Vijay
Raghavan, Principal Scientific Advisor to Government of India. So please, whomsoever has time, immediately just watch that. It's an ongoing for another 10 days. The program is for 10 days. It is organized by Indian National Science Academy, where Dr. Das is also a fellow. Rajendra Prasad is a fellow. So there are many people from Amity who are fellow of the INSA. So now please watch. And we have given you the link to every university, every campus. So those who are listening here, please try to watch whichever program of interest to you. Please open it and open the link, and then you can observe the lectures. Now with this, compliments to you, Dr. Amrish Chandra, for this 2 days event. Now I'll close it with the blessings of founder president and Dr. Dilip Upadhyaya and also Nishi Narang for taking the lead to organize this event, and Dr. Smita. And now you have a big role to play, a bigger responsibility for looking after the whole group. And you have already been associated with the IPR in a big way. Now your sole responsibility comes on your shoulders, and I'm sure you will excel. We know your commitment, loyalty, brilliance, and devotion, and also the high reliability and dependability. So we expect a lot to your contribution for the growth of Amity in research and innovation, particularly with regard to the intellectual property rights protection. So I compliment every listener, including vice chancellors and senior faculties, along with the young energetic faculties and research scholars from within Amity, and also from outside Amity, a few of them who have joined here. Best wishes, carry this message. India, the founder president has already envisioned that India will become a knowledge superpower and also a general superpower by 2030. So if that is so, that is the mandate and the vision for the country which founder has pronounced, all of us have to make it happen. Each one of us has to contribute. Founder wants to say something.
A special compliment to our Dr. Rajendra Prasad.
Dr. Rajendra Prasad. And Dr. Rajendra Prasad, I spoke to you last night as soon as founder sent that mail. I just called him. Immediately he said, yes, this will be very valuable. And then I started shooting out the mail through Dr. Goodwill Coker. At night I disturbed at 11 o'clock, she started sending the mail. Thank you so much, Dr. Goodwill, for prompt response. And wish you all the best, Dilip, for now your role to see that the product gets into the market and start generating wealth for the yeah. country, for the Amity, for all the inventors. You know, we
yes.
share that, and you have a very big responsibility with your business as well as the industry experience. You will look at it differently in a leadership role in DITT and TEC. And with the support and guidance from Dr. B.C. Das as the chief
yes.
coordinator for the TEC, as well as in the other research related issues. So you have a very, very big responsibility to show results within the 6 months. At least six technologies should reach industry. Let's set a goal for you now.
Yes. Okay.
Presence of founder and everyone. This is minimum. This is minimum. We are putting minimum. At least once a month now. But now,
yeah.
thereafter, at least 2-3 should go every year, because we have enough people and you have the capability, no know-how. And so now at least 6 will go to industry, and we should generate the both license fee as well as the royalty coming in, and look for that minimum target. This is a small minimum target
yeah.
which we have set. I'm sure you'll show the results. So thank you very much for all the viewers.
Dr. Norty, I'm going to give
thank
very strong five top industry people to Dr. Dilip Upadhyay
Yes.
Who will be doing academics, research area, and industry? Because to commercialize more than 1,000 patents is a huge challenge. But you will be getting, Dr. Ripadia, very soon, five top young, bright people, those who will run around the industry and sell your patents. So, don't worry, because I know your mammoth challenge, but I'll help you.
Yeah, I will try. I promise my level best, definitely, positively.
Okay. So thank you very much. With this, I thank every one of you and have a wonderful day ahead. And make the commitment today. Every one of us will give 100% of ours to nation building through Amity. Thank you so much.
I would like to say thank you to Founder President and all my panelists for being there all the time, giving us support and encouragement all the time. And I would also like to congratulate Dr. Amrish Chandra that he had a huge list of participants today. He shared his knowledge and replied to all the queries very nicely. Good luck to him and all
thank
the
you.
Best.
Thank you.
Compliments to you, Nishi.
Thank you, Founder Sir. Thank you, Selvamuthi Sir. Thank you, blessings from Das Sir. Great help from Upadhyay Sir and Nishi Ma'am, Smita Ma'am. All blessings. Thank you, Ma'am.
Thank you.